How to get an I-140, basically petition from your, if your employer has not given you one. And this is a question that we get very frequently, especially for those who are filing for their, what we call the H4 EAD, or for those who want to extend the H1B beyond 6 years. So they want to get a copy of that, and oftentimes the company will not release that. Unfortunately, there's no real secret how to get it, but one thing which have worked recently is what we call a FOIA request of a Freedom of Information Act request, which you can get here. As you can see, we are on the website of the USCIS. You just go on the forms and type what we call the FOIA here. You just go here, you got FOIA. And you will see it appears here. It's free, actually. You can use that also to get a copy of all your immigration documents. But here we're going to limit it to the I-140, which is the one the most helpful for people who are extending their H4. So far, no laws have passed that they have to release the I-140. But until then, hopefully, it will be passed. So first of all, you can get a couple of ways to get the FOIA request. One of them, of course, is to use the, like, if you had followed right now on the video, I went on the USCIS website and I clicked on that. You can download the form, click here, you download it, and then you fill it. Fill it with all the information that you need. And for example, here I will save it. And since it is on the Firefox, so I will open it from here. And of course, here it is, it's open. And now we are going to go ahead and continue on how we deal with that. And here it is. So this is the form, and you're requesting under the FOIA Freedom of Information Act. You type here, and then are you the subject of a record of this request? You're going to put yes, and then you put your name here. Yeah, I'm going to put my name, Shah, family name is actually family name my given name is Shah, I'm sorry, family name is Pirali, an example. And if you want something to be mailed to your attorney or something, the attorney will put their name here. And of course, you should put your phone number here. I'm going to put 510-742-5887. And if you want to put and then if you want to put a mobile, and here you can put info@pirali.law, example, I'm giving an example here, and of course you put the signature. And you don't have to state a purpose of the FOIA, but you should mention basically you want all the documents related to the I-140 petition which was filed for you, etc. And even if so, all documents related to my immigration, including I-140 petition. And the thing is, just like the FOIA, there's no guarantee, of course, they will give all the information, but you should actually mention it. And of course, you can mention the name of the company, and etc. Here, I'm not going to fill the form for you, but it would be good that if you have an E number, you put it, I-94 number, of course, it is on your 797 or on your passport, or what was given to you at the airport. So you want to put that. Fill the form. The form is pretty easy to fill, and you don't really need to give any fee. There's no fees attached to it, and then you mail the form. There's additional information. Sometimes you will want to ask a specific things, and you can mention it there. And it's not very difficult to get the FOIA. Just to let you know that I-140 that you're looking for, it's not a guarantee you will get it, by the way. Some people have been very successful in getting it, some people have not. But so far recently, because of the issues of employers canceling people's I-140, the FOIA has been very helpful to get the documents. There's another way also to get the FOIA, and of course that way is usually the way they have just started that. I think there's an app, a Freedom of Information Act app, on iPhone and also on Android. So please download it and use that. And also, if you need help on any of those issues, please feel free to call us at 510-742-5887. Having said that, ladies and gentlemen, there are also another way to get your labor certification, not your I-140. That labor certification copy might be very interesting in order for you to file for EC21 letter. And if you need help on those, we can help you, but it's pretty easy and straightforward. I am going to do another video for the labor certification, but that one is mostly for the I-140. So I just made this quick video to help you to get an idea what can be done when it comes to your FOIA. And we thank you for basically listening to all our YouTube. We recommend that you basically check all the videos we have on YouTube on this matter, and we hope you were able to. This information was helpful to you, and this was brought to you by Shah Pirali and the Shah Pirali Law Group. As you can see, you can check our website piralilaw.com, and there's a lot of information right there that can help you. And of course, if you need help, the number is on your screen, 510-742-5887. And anything I'm telling you today is for educational purposes only. You should not act or refrain to act solely on the information provided. You should contact an attorney if you have any questions. Again, feel free to call us, 510-742-5887. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Keep listening to our shows and our YouTube videos, and we hope to post more stuff soon. Thank you.